Hi everybody.
Hello.
I wasn't really planning to go live tonight, but I figure I may as well because I'm going to be using the stat cooker. And I want to make sure I can see all the comments because it's been a while. As usual, I did not plan anything for dinner. So when Ramel came home to go get ready for paddling, that was when I took the meat out of the freezer. What do you want?
Up.
Up, she says.
Hi.
Up. Hi.
Hey.
Hi. 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 So Hi. Thankfully she didn't need shots Hi. Today. It Hi. Was just giving blood. Hi. So she's a little anemic, so she needs more iron. Wait, mommy has to cook. So I'm going to use the stack cooker. I defrosted about a pound and a half of ground beef that I have here. Can you guys see? Let me turn this way so you guys can see. And this is the Pochero that my mom and my auntie made the other night. So I'm going to cook that too for the kids. So I'm actually going to take this out and hopefully, I'm really hoping that this will fit in here. It will. So I'm going to warm this up first. Pochero is like a stew, I guess. So it's just a block. I'm gonna warm this up first for a couple minutes so I can like push it down so I can stack the ground beef on top. So this is gonna go in for 3 minutes. I just want it thawed enough that I can crush it down into the stack cooker because I'm gonna cook the ground beef the same time I'm warming that up because it's still frozen. So here's the pound and a half of ground beef. I'm just gonna throw this. I soaked it in warm water for about an hour. So these are like patties. So I'm just gonna throw this in here. I'd say it's about a pound and a half of ground beef. So it thawed out pretty quickly in the freeze it containers. And I just put it in a container of like warm hot water to thaw it out. And I could put hot water all over it without water going inside the meat, as you can see. So I'm gonna take a spoon and just kind of break it up. Because I'm just going to brown it and I'm just going to add like celery, whatever vegetables I have. And so I'm doing like this keto friendly meal prep workshop thing. And it's something that I've been wanting to do for like a year and I just never like tried to do it because of fear. Mostly because I feel like it's going to flop and nobody's going to want to do it. And so I'm implementing like some of the techniques that we have learned from other leaders in Tupperware. This is the meal prepping thing is really, really big in Canada and in the mainland. And I want to try and bring it over here because a lot of people like to meal prep. And I get that it's different type of foods. Like for me, when I think of meal prepping, I think like gym people that do quinoa and broccoli and chicken breast, and you can totally do that in the stack cooker and in the grill and just prep everything. Hi Josie, hi Danny, hi Dana, hi Brittany, hi Laura, hi Desiree, hi May, hi Sheena, am I missing anybody? Jamie, Rachel, everybody, hello. Hi Renee. So I just kind of broke it up like this, and I think I'm going to just season it a little. So this is just going to be like a simple stir fry thing with veggies. That's all I'm going to do is ground beef, little table salt. It's just ground beef with broccoli and celery because that's what I have. I have not gone grocery shopping since Costco. It's just pepper. And I'm putting this on the colander because I want to drain the fat that's in here. And it's going to drain into the 1 3/4 casserole. So once this thing thaws, I can push it down. And then, she's making a mess in here. And then after I push it down, I can put this in. Because this is about a pound and a half. So 6, 7, 8 minutes or so, it should be cooked all the way through. And hopefully it doesn't form like one big hamburger blob. Because that's what happens when you cook hamburger in the microwave. So I'm just going to do it for maybe 6 minutes to start. And then while that's cooking, I'm going to chop the veggies. And then I'm going to break it apart as I'm going. So the pochero is for the kids because it's kind of soupy. I'm going to use a different spoon. It's kind of soupy because they can... No! Don't touch that. It's kind of soupy so she can eat this with rice. you know. It's a seriously a frozen block because I just took it out of the freezer. But that way they can eat this with rice, because Romella and I can't eat it because there's potatoes and beans in it, and it's not, it has carbs. So we're watching our carbs. So I'm just trying to shave this thing down so I can stack it on top. And if it doesn't work, I'm just going to stack it on top anyways. Because as it warms up, it's gonna fall down anyway. Okay, so I'm going to put this way. I know it looks funny. Hopefully it fits in a microwave. I only have one microwave. The other one is a toaster oven. Hopefully this fits. Let's see. It does. So I turned the handle. I'm going to put it in for 6 minutes. I turned the handle the other way because I want steam to vent out of it. And then while this is cooking, let me get the veggies out. So I just have celery and broccoli. I could probably use bell peppers. I have bell peppers, the 2-week-old bell peppers. Everything green. I don't really have anything red. Let's see. Let me get my bell peppers. These are the 2-week-old bell peppers, by the way. Has been 2 weeks. So this is the 2-week-old bell peppers. I guess I'll use this. No, don't touch that. This is the other 2-week-old bell pepper. Look at that. We gotta use some celery. We had broccoli yesterday, so I'm not gonna use that. No, that's yucky already. It's dry. Let mommy get the onion. Yeah, it's dry. It's dry. It's dry. Okay. We need like half an onion. I'm just throwing stuff in there. Some garlic. I'm trying to think what else I can season this with. I think the knife is down here. Or not. Oh, yeah, it's in here. It's in my dishwasher. Yes, Lynn, this is the same cutting board. You're right. How are you? I haven't seen you in a while. And I'm just wondering when you're gonna come back to Rally too. Hi Tammy, how's your doggy? Hi Corey. Hi Jen, hi Stacy. I'm just gonna use half an onion. And I'm just gonna slice it. Did you guys see that whipping accessory I used to make the frosting? All this time I thought that it was still in the vault, and they actually put it in our new they brought it back, so it's available this whole season. It's in our new catalog. I don't remember the price, but that thing works really good. As long as the cream cheese and butter is soft, like really soft and not too cold, it whips it really, really well. Like I think I cranked it 4 times and it was like super soft and fluffy. I couldn't believe it. Let me use this container. Because I'm literally just going to throw everything in the meat and put it back in the stack cooker in the microwave for like 10 minutes to cook the veggies. But this is the 2-week-old bell pepper. And this is the 2-week-old bell pepper that was in the fridge smart. Pretty cool, yeah. Hi, Yvette. I'm just kind of just making ground beef with veggies. Just kind of winging it. I'm tapping off all the extra water so that the extra moisture doesn't kill the other one. I could put broccoli in there, but we just had broccoli yesterday. So when you're using your Fridge Smarts, you always want to put it in naked and dirty. You don't want to clean it before you use it. I mean, you don't want to clean it when you're storing it, because that extra moisture is what's going to make it rot. So you want to wash it before you use it. So that's the inside. So it's pretty good for 2-week-old from the grocery store. So I'm heating up the Pochero for the kids, and I'm just making a ground beef veggie thing. I didn't want to use the stove today. I just didn't feel like it. I just got done watching, I don't know, Alex, is it done already? The leadership conference live. It was probably like, I want to say two hours long. And it was a recognition night. So it's everybody who's in the top org sales, top business leaders, and then executive director just did the walk of roses, all of that stuff. And when Tabitha was saying, like, her, I think when she said it was her first jubilee and she saw Miriam do that walk, she said, I want that too. That was the same year it was my first jubilee, and I remember seeing that walk of red roses, and I, excuse me, and I also said the same thing, like, I want that. I want to be able to do that. And so Tabitha, who was being recognized before I logged off, has been in Tupperware for 6 years. Please don't do that. Don't do that. Emily, can you give her the iPad so I can cook dinner, please? And so 6 years, and she has grown to, I want to say she has 12 directors under her. I could be totally wrong, but to be an executive director, that is huge. She has a million dollar, much more than $1 million organization. So that was pretty cool. So that's heating up. I cut my onion. Oh, garlic. A little bit of garlic. Maybe three. Emily, can you please get your sister? Romel is paddling. So today is one of those days where it's like, must be nice to be able to go work, be kidless, come home, grab your canoe, go paddling, do more adult time, and I'm stuck with the kids all day and all night. So that's why I'm looking forward to May, because in May, I'm actually going to take a whole week off. And I'm going on a trip with RJ. And Romel can figure out the kids and his job and balance all that out, because I don't know about you guys, if I'm the only mom out there that's going through this, but it's like, you know how the people that helped make these kids plan their days as if they don't have kids, and it's like, come go, because you automatically have a babysitter. Well, I don't have that leisure, because somebody else is already making their plans without considering the other people here that has a life too. Okay, so the meat is not done yet, which I expected, but I want to chop it up first. So I'm going to use the same. That's a lot of gristle. I'm just breaking it up so that it doesn't form like a meatloaf, because I don't want it to be like a meatloaf. So that was 6 minutes. So that's what it looks like so far. We're going to Vegas. Just me and him. And this is the gristle that came out of that meat. There's a lot of gristle. So now, this thing, where's my other spoon? I have a different spoon for the soupy thing. I'm gonna try and break this up some more so that I can lay the food flat. Oh, that's why. There was a bone in there. There was like a piece of bone from the pork. Okay. So I'm gonna put this back in, but this time I'm gonna add all the garlic and the onions and the veggies, and I'm gonna put this back in for another 6 minutes, and it should be done by then. The soupy thing is gonna be all warmed up. I asked Emily twice, I think, on camera if she could take her sister so I could cook, but I guess that's not happening. Okay, so I put the bell peppers, the onions, and the garlic on top. I already put salt and pepper on the meat. And if you wanted to, you can add Worcestershire, you can add shoyu, whatever you want. I'm just going to leave it like this. And we're going to put it in for six more minutes. Kimberly, you feel me? Right? Like, seriously, like, you know what? It would be different if they would ask, like, do you have something to do because I wanna da-da-da-da-da, right? Like, just being considerate of the other people, not just, oh, I gotta go, and then they leave. When it's a mom, the first thing you think of is who's gonna watch the kids before I make my plans. So, next week, what is next week? February 1st. What is today? So, next week, my schedule is super, super packed, so I'm probably not going to do many lives next week. Because next week, Thursday and Friday, I have a retreat that I have to do, and it's for directors. So we're doing a retreat. Next week, Saturday, I have a whole day doing a vendor event at the gym. So if you're at UFC Mililani, I will be there. I was going to put celery, but I think it's good with just the bell peppers and the onions. Plus, I don't have... This kid is driving me bonkers right now. So I'll be doing that event on Saturday. And then Saturday night at 6 o'clock is the meal prep thing. I don't know if we're going to check out restaurants. Really, I mean, the whole reason why we're going is because I'm going with him to EDC. So if you don't know what EDC is, it's the Electric Daisy Carnival. And it is a music festival in Las Vegas. And I think for a lot of parents, it's probably the festival you heard that kids die at because they're dehydrated and they're doing whatever it is they're doing. But I wanted to go because it's something that's been on my bucket list. And RJ has gone before, and when he told me he was going, I literally thought it was just like a rave or something. And when I saw videos about it, it was like a legitimate carnival. There's like a carnival. And so I wanted to go here. I wanted to go because I wanted to see the carnival. So that's why I want to go see that. So that's what we're going for. For me, it's adult time with no kids and no husband. You know, because Romel gets his hunting trips once or twice a year. He gets to go and do that. And my trip is like for Tupperware. So it's like a work trip. Get down. Emily, I asked you 3 times to get your sister and give her the damn iPad. Oh my God, the terrible tools. Oh, that he's cool that I'm going with him? You know, I've started seriously contemplating smoking weed. Like, I'm going to be straight up honest, dead serious right now. I'm going to have to start making some calls. Is there any moms out there that smoke weed to help them get through the day? So she didn't get shots today. She just had her blood drawn to check her. Let me wipe her face. Oh my goodness. Oh my God, I would love to come to New York. I want to go back to Times Square. Is it snowing over there today, Yvette? Is it? CBD? Smoke up. You guys crack me up. I have a basket now that I keep all of my kitchen towels in after I tidied up. I need CBD gummies. Give me the good stuff. Say hi. Naughty. She's so naughty. Oh my God. So like the other day I was trying to do work and I turned around and she got freaking slime all over the carpet. If you ever had to try to get slime out, and it's water-based, so it wasn't like that hard to remove, but it was a pain. If it helps, go for it. 4 degrees. Oh my God, Yvette, your video of you walking to the store cracked me up. It's legal there now. I think I should go to Cali. Is it legal in Vegas? She's looking at herself. So she got slime in the carpet. She got slime on her long johns. She got slime in her hair all in the same day. And then she got a pack of my post-it notes and pulled them all apart and scattered them all over the floor. She did that today. What else has she been doing? She climbs now, so she likes to climb up and touch things. So like just now she was climbing up and grabbing onions and garlic for my things. I'm peeling all the skins, which for me, I think because I spent so much time, like 2 weeks, organizing and tidying up, I'm more, I want to say motivated, but like I'm more motivated to keep everything tidy because like I invested so much time cleaning up, right? that now it's like, put the toys away. Like, you're allowed to play, but when it's time to put away, everything has to get put away. I don't like when the kitchen is messy like how it is right now. And I just put in so much work that I want to maintain it now. No, Emmy. Oh my god, please tell me dinner's done. Okay, let me put her down. She is cute. She drives me nuts. Hold on a moment. Let me check. The fried rice I made yesterday for them, they're going to eat that leftover. Okay, so ooh, this thing smells good, you guys. Oh, my glasses. Okay, so there. I'm just going to stir it up. I don't want to overcook it because it's still going to keep cooking even after the microwave is off. And get down. Get down. One. Two. Okay, so let me stir this up. Everything is nice and bright. All the gristle fell to the through the colander, so it's not cooking in fat. So I'm gonna stir this up. I'm gonna add a little bit of what is the problem?
No, mine.
This is yours. Take it. Take it. Yeah, she's totally taking over for Emily. Seriously. Okay, so you could add like your if you have like fajita mix, you could add this and eat it like that. I'm just gonna eat it like this. So there's the finished ground beef with bell peppers and onions, and this took a total of 12 minutes cooking time. All the gristle drained underneath, so I'm gonna take this so you can see. Look at this, is how much fat came out of it. That was about a pound and a half. So if you were cooking this on the stove, you would have to cook it and then drain it, which is a pain in the butt. But now it's all done. And before you guys like have a fit, I actually have a jar here to collect fat, so that's not going down the drain. That goes in the dishwasher and my spoon for the sauce. So this thing is pretty heated up already, and it was at one time a stew, but now I think it's like a soup. So I just have to mix it up and let it sit, and it'll warm up the little piece there for now. See, dinner is done right on time, you guys. Yes, I don't have keto-friendly wraps with me right now. 5 degrees outside, forget it. Right now, I think it's 70 over here, kind of rainy. So there's the Pochero reheated. It's more like a soupy Mama. Stew now. Mama. She knows it's time to eat. And so here's the meat. So the meat is done. This is what we're eating. The kids are going to eat this. I'm going to scoop some up for Crybaby here. One moment, please. Good gosh. Wait. Oh, one. Two. Let me give her some soup. This is the spoon for the soup. You want soup? Okay.
Yeah.
You want soup?
Yeah.
Okay. Let me, the good thing is now that this is like really, extra super soft, I can just smash it all up. Want to trade places? You know what? I would. Negative 30. I've been seeing all of the videos of, how cold it's been in the mainland and how like the cloves and the noodles are all frozen. Let me just check how hot it is. So this has potatoes, beans, carrots, cabbage, but it's like disintegrated now. Let's see if she'll eat the carrot. She used to like carrots as a baby. So this thing, is it too hot? It heated up to just about right because there was a tiny piece that was still cold. So I mixed it all up so it wouldn't be too hot. Blow. Okay, why don't you sit down? She's 21 pounds, by the way, which is pretty light for her age, but which is surprising to me because she eats a crap ton. But she also runs around and climbs a lot, so now they get to watch you eat. You guys haven't watched her eat in a while.
Yummy.
Yummy. You tell the world it's yummy. You have to blow, sister. Blow. Up next is potty training. How fun is that gonna be? You guys get to live that with us. Watch her freaking potty train. Well, not watch, but you know what I mean. You guys got to watch her walk and crawl and all that stuff. Stand up. I think you guys sent me screenshots of that too. Blow. Blow. Emily, that is... Blow. Blow.
Pad?
No, there's no pad. She's hogging it. Blow. Blow. Is it yummy? They asked if you said, is it yummy? Is it yummy? Yummy? Is it? Don't stick your finger in there. Is it yummy? Blow efficiently. Go. Blow. Wow.
Fresh.
Fresh? Fish? What?
Fish.
Yeah, fish. That's not fish. Blow.
Fish?
Blow.
Fish?
What? There's no fish. Blow. You don't want to blow? That's vegetables. You want meat?
Fudge.
That's food. Yes. Oh my gosh, she's going to eat this whole bowl. This fish. Totally will be my last potty training. Fish. There's no more. Okay, blow.
Fish.
Blow. Well, she likes Pochero. And if you want to know how to make fish. Pochero, it's on my mom's cooking fish. Page. Cooking with Mama.
Fish.
Open. Look at yourself. Look. Look. Here.
Fish.
So back to that whole meal prep class that I want to do. If no one registers for it, I'm still going to do it. And I'm probably going to live it while I'm doing it. Okay, what in the world? Open your mouth. I'm still going to do it so I can show you guys what it is that I had planned to do. And it's my first one, so I don't feel like defeated if no one registers, because I get it. It's something new. And people might have questions about the registration fee. So the $100 is to cover the groceries. And also the Tupperware, because I put down $40 credit on there because I wasn't sure yet if I was going to buy Tupperware for people to put their food in or just give them a credit towards their order because they already paid. You know what I mean? So they can use it against the order they want. And the reason I didn't want to do the buy the Tupperware first is I don't think it's going to get in time for the class. And number two, I might order something that maybe they don't want. Maybe they want to use it on freezer containers or microwave containers and not so much the fresh and cool containers for food prep. So that's why I didn't want to like buy the products and then for them, you know what I mean? If you lived here, you would go. I got a lot of responses like that, and I was thinking, is it scheduling, because it's a Saturday night? It's not gonna take more than an hour, I would think, to put everything together. Actually putting it together, it would probably last longer than an hour because we're talking and having fun and enjoying each other's company. Because I actually attended one of these meal prep classes before with our business leader, and that was like totally not keto food. So if nobody wants to do the keto friendly, then I'm gonna do the next one as a non-keto where it's full of pasta and pasta sauce.
Yummy. What's this?
Pochero.
Pochero.
Fish.
What is pochero?
The stew.
Fish.
Okay. So that's what we're going to do. You're welcome to come.
Who?
Noe.
Fish.
But there's still a fee. Because I got to buy the groceries. Fish. That's why. That's why I need all the registrations by Tuesday the 5th. Because that's when the sale ends. For all the groceries. It just so happened that all the recipes I was thinking about doing, the groceries were on sale. So that way I can fit it. Because in Hawaii, $60 worth of groceries for family for meals for five nights is a stretch because everything is expensive here. Like right now, cabbage is on sale for 99 cents a pound. I think chicken thighs, boneless, skinless, is on sale for $2.69 a pound or $2.99 a pound. Cauliflower is on sale for $2.69 a pound. That's a sale price over here. And so the bonus was to make cauliflower rice, and so blow. So it's really like, that was my budget, was $60 per person that came to bring their meals for a family of four for 5 days. So to go home with meals for five and it's about $60, that's pretty cheap. And the corned beef is on sale. So that's, I have to go get that at Long's. Here. Okay, no, she don't. Okay, no. Okay, go daddy then. I made ground beef with bell peppers and onions. All done already. And I heated up the Pochero stew that my mom made for the kids.
When she made this?
I don't know. When Auntie Eleanor was here. So I just, that's dinner. Super fast. Okay. So we're going to sign off.
Hi, Noi. She's asking what you're cooking.
I did. I just showed her what it was.
Hi, Laura and Christine and Yvette.
What's the problem? Who's outside? More? Okay, no more. Okay, bye everybody. We'll see you guys tomorrow.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. She just burped.
Bye-bye.